Hi, and welcome to this Friday's 5-minute consult with your favorite family medicine doc. In these videos, I discuss everything that you need to know about some of the most common health conditions listed from A to Z. And today's topic starts with the letter K. So let's talk about kidney stones. What are they? Kidney stones are small, hard objects that form in the kidneys when there is not enough fluid to wash away an excess buildup of minerals or salts. They can range in size from a smaller size, similar to that of a grain of salt, all the way up to a larger size, similar to that of a kernel of corn. They can range in color as well, from brown to white to yellow, and they can be rough or smooth. What are the symptoms? You can have kidney stones without any symptoms, but this is only if they are staying where they are formed and not passing through the small tubes called ureters. If you do have a kidney stone that is trying to pass from the kidney to the bladder, then you will have some symptoms, and these include pain in one side of your lower back, which can range from mild to moderate to severe. Also, pain in your lower abdomen or groin area, which can range in severity and also come and go. Changes with your urination, including an increased frequency of urination, urgency, a burning sensation while you urinate, or also if you have urine that is dark, cloudy, or has blood in it. If you develop a urinary tract infection while you have a kidney stone, then you can also develop fever, chills, and nausea or vomiting. You will want to see your doctor if you are experiencing severe lower back pain or abdominal pain, as well as fever, if you have blood in your urine, or if it's hard for you to urinate. What is the cause? Kidney stones form when there is an excess buildup of minerals, and these include calcium, oxalate, and uric acid. Both men and women can get kidney stones, but men are more likely to get them than women by 2 to 1. Certain powder drinks can lead to kidney stones because they can clump up if they are not mixed very well and if there is not enough fluid to pass through the kidneys. Some medications can lead to kidney stones, and these include a diuretic, which is a form of a blood pressure medication. If you eat a diet rich in protein, this can lead to an excess buildup of uric acid. And if you eat a diet rich in calcium, you can have an excess buildup of the calcium mineral in your kidneys. Sometimes taking an excess amount of a vitamin C supplement can lead to kidney stones, and one of the major causes of kidney stones is dehydration. Other risk factors may include pregnancy, obesity, having a family history of kidney stones, and having constant diarrhea leading to dehydration. Now let's go over the types of kidney stones. There are 4 types of kidney stones that we are going to go over today, and the first one is calcium stones. This is the most common type of kidney stone, and calcium, or oxalate, is a mineral that builds up within the kidneys if you are taking in too much vitamin D, or if you are taking in too much calcium within your diet. You can also get this type of kidney stone if you are very dehydrated, or you sweat a lot and you don't replace your fluids. The next type of kidney stone is known as the cystine stone. This is the least common kidney stone, and it is genetic. There is a certain gene that predisposes you to getting this type of stone, and if you do get this type of stone, you will get it again in the future. The next type of stone is known as the struvite stone. This one is basically caused by urinary tract infections. And the last type of stone that we are going to talk about today is known as the uric acid kidney stone. And this kidney stone is more common in patients who have diabetes, who have chronic diarrhea, or who have a history of gout. If you have gout, you know that eating certain foods can lead to a flare-up of gout, and this is the same for kidney stones. Foods that are high in proteins or something known as purines can lead to an increase of uric acid and therefore a flare-up of gout or a kidney stone as well. Diagnosis. Kidney stones are most commonly diagnosed if you are having active symptoms of a kidney stone, including pain. However, your doctor is also going to ask if you have a history of kidney stones. A blood test can determine the health of your kidneys, as well as detect if you have any excess calcium or uric acid within the body. A urine test can rule out any urinary tract infection, and there is a special urine test that lasts 24 hours that can detect if you have any minerals built up within the urine. Imaging studies can also help a doctor diagnose a kidney stone on X-ray. If it is a larger stone, it will show up, but for smaller kidney stones, a CT will need to be done. And lastly, a kidney stone can be diagnosed by examining the actual stone. Sometimes your doctor will give you a strainer to urinate in and that will catch the stone. They then can send it to the lab and see what type of mineral your stone is made of. What is the treatment? Like we talked about, if you have a kidney stone but it is not passing through the ureter and causing you any symptoms, then you may not need any treatment. If you are experiencing symptoms from the passage of a kidney stone, you will want to increase your fluids. You want to be drinking anywhere from 8 to 10 8-ounce glasses of water per day so that the water can flush through and break up any minerals that have built up. And a good indicator to tell if you are drinking enough fluids is that the clearer your urine is, the better. For pain, you can take over-the-counter ibuprofen or naproxen. And lastly, if needed, your doctor can provide you with a medication called an alpha blocker. This medication works by relaxing the muscles of the ureter, which is the tube that the kidney stone is passing through. This medication will help you pass the stone quicker and easier and with less pain. If you are one who suffers from larger kidney stones that do not easily pass and require extra treatment, you may need to see a specialist known as a urologist to help perform special procedures to break up your kidney stones. Today I'm going to be discussing four types of these special procedures, and the first one is known as extracorporeal shockwave therapy, or ESWL. This is one of the more common treatments of larger kidney stones in the United States. It uses shock waves to blast the kidney stone into little pieces that can then be passed easier. Your doctor will talk to you about performing this procedure either under local anesthetic or general anesthesia. The procedure takes about 1 hour, and then your doctor will monitor you afterwards for about 1 hour before sending you home. The next procedure is known as a urotoscopy. This is a small flexible camera that they pass through the urethra, then through the bladder, then through the ureters, up toward the kidney to find the kidney stone and help remove it. This is also a same day procedure, but you will likely be asleep for this procedure. The next procedure is actually a surgery, and this is known as a percutaneous nephrolithotomy. With this surgery, your doctor is going to make a small incision in your low back, which leads straight to the kidney, and then remove the kidney stone. Because it is more of an invasive surgery, you will likely spend a few days in the hospital to recover from this surgery. And the last treatment that I wanted to discuss today is also a surgery known as a parathyroidectomy. The parathyroid is a gland in your neck that can lead to the excess production of a specific hormone that can lead to kidney stones, specifically the calcium oxalate kidney stone. Therefore, by removing this gland, you can prevent your risk of getting this type of kidney stone. Complications. Complications are more common if you have larger kidney stones. This can lead to a blockage in the ureter, which causes you to have trouble urinating. It can also lead to damage of the ureter. You can also experience a lot of pain as well as bleeding with urination. You may also develop a urinary tract infection, and if it becomes severe enough, it can lead to something known as sepsis, and if untreated, that can lead to death. Now let's talk about prevention. If you have had a kidney stone, there is a high chance that you will get another one at some point in your lifetime, so it's very important to know how to prevent it for the future. One of the best ways to prevent kidney stones is to make sure that you never become dehydrated. And one of the ways you can do this is by drinking your proper amount of fluids, which includes 8 to 10 8-ounce glasses of fluids per day. You want to be avoiding certain foods that can lead to kidney stones, and this can include eating an excess amount of animal proteins. You want to stick to smaller serving sizes of steaks or red meats. Other foods that can lead to kidney stones include eggs, spinach, nuts, chocolate, or soda. If you suffer from uric acid kidney stones, you want to be avoiding foods that are high in purines, which can also lead to a gout flare-up. I did a video all about gout, so you can watch that video to see what types of foods to avoid. And lastly, if you suffer from calcium kidney stones, you want to be decreasing the amount of salt that you take in your diet because sodium can actually increase the amount of calcium mineral within your body. And that wraps up our discussion today on kidney stones. I hope that you found this information helpful and informative. If you have any other questions, please let me know in the comments. I would be happy to answer those for you. If you would like to see more educational videos like these, be sure to subscribe as I am making new videos every Friday. And I will see you on the next video. Until next time, bye!